Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Sandy Bay, we're here. I had a brief introduction this morning, and, well, it's supposed to be brief. It ended up not being brief, but that's just because I have the ability to talk non-stop for weeks on end without stopping. Moving swiftly on, I was going to do some grass today. We've got 100 cows, they're already here, they're ready to go, and I'm trying to decide which tractor to use. Now, those are the standard game tractors over there. I didn't really want to use those, so I had to decide between this hurlimann. Is it? Yeah, hurlimann. I'm not sure how you pronounce it with the two little dots above the U. It is slightly different, or the Ursus. So, I will just take a quick note. I don't want to look in that one. I look in this one, and I want to see what horsepower they are. So we've got the Ursus, which is 148 horsepower, and I've got the hurlimann, which is 130 horsepower. So I think I will go for this task. You know what? I'm going to go for the hurlimann anyway. So I've got a mower, which is this Pottinger one. This requires a 70 horsepower mower. I want a front-mounted one. I've got this Coon here, which is the standard game one. Requires 90 horsepower, or I could go. I did have a modded one, didn't I? And my modded one was this one, this Fent one, or I could go for this Coon one here. That's 3.3. That one, I have no idea what that one is. And then, of course, I got those trailed ones. Oh, I've got another Coon over here. This one, that's 3.3 as well. Right, well, that one's 11,000. That one's 10,000. And how much is the standard game? I forgot to check that. So let's have a look at that. This one is 13,500. So let's go with that Fent one. That's the one that we were using in... no, we won't use that. We'll use this one. The FC313F. That's £11,800. So there's that one purchased. Back and back. And now if we just take a quick look at the map, I want to, today, I want to do some grass cutting. And... no, I want to go here, map, view. So we've got ready to harvest. Now, fruit types. This grass in these three fields. Field 35 is actually part of the cows. So the cows are in that field and wandering around. So we're 31 and 30. And then we've got wheat further down at field 29. So we'll start harvesting, possibly even tomorrow, on that one. 36, I'm not sure if that is sunflowers or if it's canola. Could be either. So I would like to take a look at that. I need to go and get this new mower that we've got. So let's start up. No, we're going to use the hurlimann because I have not used that one at all. I have used the Ursus. I think I used that in my very early time lapse. I can't remember now. So let's start this one up. There we go. I need to drop this weight off somewhere because we're just going to use the front-mounted mower and then we'll have the rear-mounted one that's here. And then we will come back and I think what we'll do is upgrade our Pottinger as well. We'll sell that one. I'm going to drop this weight right here. Lower that down. I've seen far enough that I can still get in to unhitch that one. There we go. That tractor jumped up quite a lot then. I did have that quite low. That is quite heavy. It's a little bit too heavy, I think, for this particular tractor. So let's have a look inside this one very quickly. There's a nice little control on there for the... that would be the gear shift. Usual standard controls. And you can't ever see quite behind the seat. Oh, there. Oh, you got up and down on the hydraulics just behind you there. Usually on tractors, if you want to actually lower the main hitch, you've got to... oh, I'm going to have to move the loader out the way. I'll leave that mower there for now, and we'll come back and get that one in a minute. On tractors, if you want to actually lower the... if you want to lower the actual hitch on the back, what you've got to do is you've got to... there's a little lever behind your seat, and you've got to lift the lever, which is a direct sort of... is a cable that runs right down to the hitch. You lift the whole linkage up as high as you can. You pull the lever up, and then the cable sort of goes down to two hooks that are fastened onto the hitch, the actual hitch bit. I'm not explaining this very well. And that then, once you pull the cable up, it releases the hitch so that you can then lower it back down. And that's how you go through them. I think the newer ones are like electronically done, so you don't have to do anything like that. Now, is that canola in there or is that sunflowers? You know, it would help if I put those on. And I really should have my beacons on. I do apologize for that. That is canola in there, isn't it? Yes. So we've got a field of canola there, field 36. Field 33. That isn't yet grown. And, I nearly forgot. I am so sorry. I completely forgot. My weekly question, the first question for the map is, do you want me to do potatoes? Because I haven't done potatoes on any of the maps. I did on Old Times because it was already planted. Do you want me to, one of the fields that he's ploughed up and ready but not sown, would you like me to plant potatoes on it? I think that would be something new for us to do. Head to the comment section down below. Let me know what you think. It's your vote. It's your game. Do you want me to do potatoes? Right, I'm going to go to the shop and we can get our new mower. Driving along the seafront here, you've got people walking up and down on the seafront. Tiny little cottages overlooking. And these are quite old cottages. I would say, I'd guess, are around about 250 years old. The smallish windows are an indication of how old the houses are, because the smaller the windows, the older they are. If they're less than 100 years old, the windows got quite a bit bigger. But the older houses, the way that they kept the houses warm was to have very small windows. And of course, when they were first built, they wouldn't have had glass either. So you didn't want these huge, great big gaping holes, especially if you're looking over the sea like that. Now, I'm going to go and pick that one up. Our new coon mower. Come round. And we can hitch this one into our pottinger that we've got, so that will work out quite nicely. So let's hitch that one up, and I will fasten on the PTO as well. Let's pick that up. Oh, that is brilliant. Right, so that lifts up like that. Now I've got to get this one back up, and I probably should have brought the mower for the back with me. Now, which way am I going to go back? Go along the seafront again, or I could, no, I don't want to go up the other way, that's going to be too far out of my way. I want to go along the seafront and then head up. Yeah, I'll get back to the farm, I'll figure out a way, I'll get back to the farm and I'll meet you back there. Well, I immediately went out the way that I said I didn't want to go, purely because I wanted to have a look around the map some more. And oh, this is fantastic. I love this map. This is such a beautiful map. I mean, if this is what we're looking at in Farming Simulator 15, what is it going to be like in Farming Simulator 17? Now, I've heard a few reports, a few people complaining about how it's, you know, far too similar to this one, and, you know, gaming as we know it is all coming to an end, and it's the end of the world, because what we've seen so far of Farming Simulator 17, it doesn't look that different to 15. Personally, I think the graphics look slightly better. It's not hugely different, but they do look improved. And the little drip details that I have seen all over the place, I think we are going to be in for some real visual treats once we get going with 17. I think it is going to be amazing. I am so looking forward to it. So anyway, that bit aside, we are going to mow field 31, which is right next to us. I'm not going to go into the cow fields just yet. We'll do that one. Okay, I might do two fields. We could do field 31 and turn that one into hay, and we could do field 32 and turn that one into, just use that as straight grass. So let me just come over here. Right, I need to move that loader out of the way, and then we can get going. So run over here, start you up. Wait for preheater. I'm in a terrible hurry. I want to get going with this. I want to do that. Right, I'm going to move these around and hitch up, and then I will, whoa, a bit of lag right there. It spiked right down to 12 frames a second. That's not very good. And then I'm up to 50 again. Yeah, there seems to be just like random patches of lag spikes. They're just very, very weird random patches of lag spikes. I'm not quite sure why. Hopefully we won't have to change. Although I have spoken to a few people and they said there's not that much of a visual difference. Once you sort of watch half an episode, you don't even notice that you're playing on medium settings instead of high settings. So just fasten those up there. And I have actually remembered to put the PTO on. There have been times when I haven't remembered to do that. So let me just fold up that mower. There we go. Beautiful. Now, hopefully, this tractor can handle all of this. It's a 130 horsepower tractor, so I don't see why it won't. You know, 130 horsepower, we do sort of sneer at these mid-level tractors. But 130 horsepower is a phenomenal amount of power. It really is. That is a huge, huge amount of power. So there's no reason that this tractor can't handle the two mowers. It should be able to cope with it just fine. Right, we'll come down into here. This one doesn't actually have a gate on it. We come past the old cultivator and elevator that are in the hedge there, and there's a combine there as well, I think. Oh no, it's a bulldozer. There's a bulldozer just out there. There, see? Right, and we will start right here, going around clockwise. Yeah, clockwise. Sorry, I'm just trying to think which way around I'm wanting to be facing. So, let's unfold our mower. That one can come out and then drop down. Going to try and do at least the first round from inside the cab. Although I will want to go outside the cab purely because it does look fantastic. So now I'll switch to the front. Lower you down. Start you up as well. Now, can this tractor do it? Seems to be. It's a little bit slow starting, but I think it's alright. So we'll do this field with... not sure if I'll do this field as hell. Right, that's actually quite slow coming up round here. So it does seem to make it grunt a little bit. We come along the edge, we've got a track along here. And that goes out into another field there. What's field 30? I'll tell you what, we might actually just do field 30 and this one so that we don't have to worry about opening the gate in for the cattle. We'll only have to do that when we go in to feed them, because their trough is in the field. And we will need to go and get that water bowser and fill that one up with water, run that in for the cattle as well, and then when we buy all the other animals, we'll need to be doing the same for them. Obviously, the beef and pigs, they're over at Willow Farm, so I'm not going to start on them just yet. I'll probably leave it a couple of weeks before I get them. And then we'll be having to travel back and forth across the map, different areas. Right, there's that little bridge that we came across. We'll go out of cab on our next round so that we can sort of see some of these wonderful details that this map's got to offer. There's no need to hug right to the edge. We don't need to do any of that. Don't worry about that. Let's look behind us. Excellent, that's cutting quite nicely. And, right, I'm going to avoid the tree a little bit. If you go too close to trees, if you've got overhanging trees, you can start picking up sticks and stuff, which can cause a bit of a problem. Of course, now we've got to go uphill. This tractor may not be the best one for this job. I was hoping that we'd be able to cope with it, but we're only doing 3-4 miles an hour. We might want to step it up and go for that Ursus, which was 160 horsepower, that one? I can't remember now. Right, I'll finish this round, and then when I come out of cab, we can have another look and see how we're getting on. Right, there's the first round done, and just starting on the second one. This mower, I think, cuts out slightly to the side of it. It sort of seems to cut just a little bit further out than the actual mower reaches. There's a bit of grass that we missed there. I'm guessing that it is a bit too much of a bump in the field for the mower to cope with. And once you get up to the top, going downhill, it's grand. It's absolutely wonderful. You've got no problems at all. You're flying through it. And the side mower, actually, because the front mower is taking such a wide swath, the side mower isn't doing all that much. It's doing all right, I guess. And we can have a look at that little bridge down there. We're going to sort of pause a minute when we get down there. Take a look at that. I like the grass texture that they're using here. This isn't my one that I changed to. And I do, I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I apologize that I lost the link for that one. I've never been able to find it since. I've had a rough idea, but I don't know which one it is that I swapped over to. Which is a bit of a shame. That looks really cool. Nice little water pond there. It's just these little details that make a map. And sometimes when you're looking through a map, you sort of, you know, they've got some nice details which are good. And you sort of say, oh, that looks nice. And then other times you look through a map and the details just make you go, wow, that is amazing. That is absolutely amazing. And this map appears to be one of the ones that genuinely makes me go wow. And that is saying something, because I have mentioned it before. You guys are sort of getting accustomed to this. I am really fussy. I'm very, very picky. I can very easily find faults in a lot of things. And so for a map to genuinely make me go wow, it has got to be above and beyond what you would normally expect from a map. And this is making me go wow. Okay? So, well done to Oxygen David, the original creator of this map. And well done to Ozzy Lee, the guy that edited this version. He added in a whole load of stuff himself. And I haven't even begun to scratch the surface. It's a shame, really. I probably should have started on... Well, I couldn't start on this one because it was only released like a week ago or 2 weeks ago. So, yeah, we didn't have all that long on it. I forgot to set my timer, so I have absolutely no idea how long I've been doing this. But I'm going to stop talking now, and I'm going to finish this field, finish all the mowing, because we've seen the mowing, and then we can at least sort of make a start on the next field, and that will be it for today's episode, I would think. We'll just do mowing today. Then tomorrow we can do a bit of baling. Well, no, we've got to do tedding or turning, depending where you come from. We could do some rake. We've got to rake it all up, and then we're going to feed some straight grass, and we're going to feed... yeah, we're going to bale up some. I'm not quite sure what we're going to do yet. So I'll decide on that tomorrow. I'll sort of make my mind up a bit later on. I'm not going to commit myself just yet to anything. So I'll finish this field a minute. I have decided to take the hurlimann off of the two mowers, and I've just gone and picked up this Ursus, which actually sounds really cool. It's got a different tone to it than a lot of them. I got partway up the hill on this third round, and I thought, you know what, 4 miles an hour, maximum top speed coming up this hill. I know it's quite a steep hill, and, you know, probably we'd need like a 300 horsepower tractor to come motoring up here at any kind of speed, but still. I thought we'd give this one a go and see if it was any improvement on the Ursus, on the hurlimann, rather. So I'm going to get hitched into here, and then I'll get mowing, and we can have a look at it in a minute. Okay. We had a hill start on it, and it started out at 5 miles an hour instead of 4. And it's already picking up speed as we come up to the top of the hill. This one seems a little bit better suited to it. I don't think we need to go much bigger than this. We could stick on one of the Deutz tractors, and I will be using that Deutz Warrior quite a bit. That is a monster of a tractor, but I do want to use, like I said, I think I said in Melbury Estate, I wanted to try and use some of the medium range tractors. So this is definitely a medium range tractor. It's one of the earlier ones available on the list, but yeah, thought that'd be pretty cool. So we're going to use this one. Let me spin around a minute, and I'm going to go on and finish doing this field. He's got a very slow start on this one, and then it sort of builds up speed as you go. And we're flying off down here now than we were with the last one. So I will go on and finish this field now, and then we can start on the next one. I got the rest of this field to finish. But I figured what I would do is... Oh, and by the way, I have switched it over to 5x speed, which it wasn't on previously. I do apologise for that, but it is on there now, so everything is tickety-boo. I'm going to come into this next field purely because I wanted to do the outside round here so we could take a look at it. And then I'll finish doing all the mowing before next episode. I'll sort of jump through and do all of that. And... I think we're going to need to mow this as two separate fields, because you can't go mowing across the track like that. That is just not on. There's something interesting about this. The front mower is obviously it's the modded one and not the standard stock game, stock option. If you have the thing... Oh, no, I want to go to the front. Engage it. And then try to reverse. Oh, no. It was reversing up the hill. It would not let me reverse up the hill. It did not like it. As soon as I switched that front mower off, it was fine. Now, I don't know if it's something to do with just that mod, or if it's just this tractor is a little bit weak. I genuinely don't know, but it's something I've not really encountered before. So I just got to bring that to your attention. I tell you what, we'll get up to the top, and we'll have a go and see about just backing up a little bit. So I'm just going to cut out this section here. And I'm not going to get too close. All the hedges have got collision. Oh, and by the way, that little shed there, that little tiny one, that's actually our wood chip storage in there. It's a nice little tidy shed off to the side. It's perfect. And I'm going to stay out from the hedge so that we don't damage any machinery or anything like that. We don't need to squeeze in really super tight. You know, the sheep don't actually have that big field. It's just a tiny little field in there. If you were going to get, like, 500 sheep, not sure how well they would fit in there. Right. Let me just do this. Now you watch. See, I'm backing up. Okay, it's not going to do it now. It was doing it, even I was on a hill, but it did. It really struggled until I turned the front mower off. I tried it with the back mower, and no difference. But then when I turned the front one off, and I had the back one going again, so I was just sort of testing them individually, the front one is the one that was doing it. I've not seen that before, so it was just an interesting little moment there I thought I'd share with you. And stone wall along here. I live in Cornwall in the UK, which is right next door to Devon in the UK, and this map is sensational. I am seeing bits of Devon all over it, and like places that I've visited on the road signs. Exeter is one of the biggest cities in Devon, right in the middle it is, and I've been there many times. I'm actually planning to go there next week, so it's really cool seeing the signs for Exeter on the roads and things like that. So I've never actually been. I don't know if Sandy Bay is an actual place. I don't think it is. I think the actual Sandy Bay is a made-up place, but if it's not, I fully intend to go here. I am going to actually go here, and I may even, if it's a real place, I'll take photos, and I will post them on my Facebook page and my Twitter feed, and you can take a look at them. But I'll have to find that out. I'll let you know in the next episode if it's an actual real location or not. If it is, that would be really, really cool. That is just something that would be awesome. So I will, actually, I'm going to just finish this round on this bit, and then we will start on the outside round of the next field, so we can sort of take a look at that field and the views from it, and then I will bid thee farewell, because I've probably gone over time already. Like I said, I've lost my timer. Right, just go across the track here, and then we can start doing round this one. I like that we've got a series of telegraph poles running across this field, especially down there in the wheat. That is going to be brilliant for combining round. It's just going to add a whole extra dimension to having to combine that field. So there's the two mowers engaged. Right, so my question for this week, do you want me to grow and harvest potatoes whilst I'm playing this map? If you do, I will plant them fairly quickly so that we do actually get round to doing them before we switch over to Farming Simulator 17. Head down to the comment section down below. Let me know what you would like. It's your vote. It's your game. So we'll just come down through here, and we've got a nice little cottage going away down there. He's fire burning and everything else. I don't know if my combine is actually going to fit around those telegraph poles. I've got a 9-meter header. So now we've got to find out if it's actually going to fit between those poles. It should do. Should. But should and would are two different things entirely. Right, swing round here. We can leave the corners, that'll be just fine. You know, you don't need to go right into the corners like that. And I'm leaving a good section up against the hedge as well, purely because I choose to. Right, come up through here. It's going to slow down a little bit here. It's not as much as it did in the other field, but it's quite a bit steeper going up that other side of the field than it is over here. This has leveled out a lot more, so we're achieving 9 miles an hour. That's pretty good. And so that's what these three fields have got to offer. I will finish mowing these, and then we can decide what we're going to do with them exactly next episode. We're going to have to row them up. We will gather it all up one way or another, and then we can feed our cattle. And then once we've got the cattle with some food, or the beginnings of food, we'll need to provide water for them. I'm going to buy some chickens. I don't want to buy too many, because I do want to keep hold of some money. And once we have done that, we'll be combining that field right in front of us. That one is ready to go, and we can try out the Rossel Mash Combine, because I've not seen that one in use yet. But if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.